We are beginning tonight with a tragic end to a missing persons case on the Central Coast.
The body of a 24-year-old man was found in an Aromas pond today, nearly 2 weeks after he went missing. After getting into a disagreement with his parents, Nelson Hardy ran out of their home and hadn't been seen since. That is, until a fisherman found him today. With more on tonight's top story, here's Action News reporter Tom Miller live in Salinas.
Aaron, that night Nelson ran out, his parents chased after him and then they searched for him, but they were never able to find him. And tonight we spoke with his mother, who got very emotional when talking about her son.
There wasn't anything he wouldn't do. He was wonderful.
Nearly 2 weeks after Nelson Hardy went missing, his family finally has an answer, though it wasn't the one they wanted. His mother says there was reason to worry even before he disappeared.
He got a little tied up with some bad things, and we were in counseling. We were doing everything possible to help him.
She was so concerned about his mental health that she sought an involuntary psychiatric hold, saying he posed a danger to himself.
And they refused him, and they said he disqualified. And I'm going to find out why, because he needed help.
The help he did get from counseling wasn't enough, and Tuesday his body was found in this pond near the family home by a friend of Nelson's who was fishing.
The fisherman was standing along the edge of the pond here when he peered through the reeds and thought he saw a hand sticking out of the water. That's when he called 911.
The area that we were in was about chest deep, and so we would think that a person in good health would be able to stand up in there.
As word of his death spread, friends visited the pond and a memorial was created in front of the family's feed store. The sheriff's office says there are no signs of foul play at this time, but his mother has her doubts.
There's a lot of things going on right now that we need to find out about some things. That is really horrible.
And there's no word yet on if drugs or alcohol played a factor, but we should get some answers when we get back the autopsy results in a couple of days. Aaron.
All right, Tom, thank you. This area, including the pond, had also been searched before by a sheriff's search and rescue team, along with Hardy's friends and family. That was right after he went missing. But at that point, there was no sign of him until today.